This helpful trailhead about nonprofit cloud shows you how to work with program and benefits. First step is to build a trial org. And so what I wanted to do was just to show you how all this worked for me. What I found is that if you're building multiple versions, make sure that you change your company name. When you view your trial org, what you're going to see is put a suffix in. And know that after you submit, it does take like almost 10 minutes for it to build, so it may take a bit of time. First step is to create a unit of measure. And what you're going to see is they regularly go out to the app launcher. So what I did was to build out a trial org navigation, which includes basically all of the objects that we're using in these trailheads. It was just a way to be able to move between them. So the first one is unit of measure, and we're going to create a new one. And you can see here I've got all units of measure. So this is what exists in the trial. Clicking new, you're required to do name, unit code, and also type. If you click type, it's period or not applicable. Looking back at the instructions, they want dollar value, value of goods, and not applicable. And so filling in those, also not applicable, and click save. Going back out, we now have one. And notice that none of the trials actually have description for the units of measure, but this one does. If you go out to the, and this is using the Atlas, this is a case management data model, and I'll make sure this is in the notes to this video. Floating down, you get the whole view. But what we're looking at doing is building program and a benefit. You can see this actually showing up in the care plan section of the. I built this out in Google Slides, but just a helpful way for me to understand it. So if we're looking at benefits, we have to have a program, we have to have a unit of measure, and we also have to have a benefit type. You know, a program can have many benefits, but a benefit can only be aligned with one program and aligned with one benefit type. So this is where you have to be a little bit strategic around how you create these benefit types, which is the next one. So we did a unit of measure. And now we're looking at creating a benefit type. Here's the information. And again, rather than going out here, I could go out to here, but I built this so I can use it. So I'm going to go to benefit type. You see we have these in the trial org. Clicking new, we're required to give it a type name and a process type. Currently just program management. It's also a service option. So in order to create a benefit type, we need to have created the unit of measure, which we did in the prior step. We can save it. Again, these benefit types are a great way to be able to categorize information. Each benefit has only one program. So you may have several benefits, or really these again are services that will look very similar. So you can group them by benefit type for reporting purposes. In a prior module in this stream, they did link to this helpful examples. Taking a look at this first one, I'll do a separate video talking about this one specifically because I think it's very helpful, but just know that when we talk about benefit types, there'll be another good example of that. So if our goal is to create a benefit, what we're looking at here is a program has benefits, and so we need to make sure the program exists. We already have a unit of measure and a benefit type. So next step is let's go in ahead and build the program. Here are their instructions. Notice again, they're encouraging you to go to the app launcher to get programs. But I'm going to go to this tab here, and I'm going to see my existing programs with details. I'm going to click new. Requiring name and start date. We also have a status option, but that's just basically letting us know where it is in the process. So fill it in as suggested. Let me go back out to programs and take a look and see that in fact it was added food systems development. Once you've built the program, you can then add benefits. Benefits are like services, so you can have lots of these that you're going to be tracking on. This is a look at the benefits included in the trial org, sorted by benefit type. And if we sort it by program instead, end up with food distribution as multiple types of services, of benefits. So let's create a new one. The required fields are name and type. And type is, again, a search field. This is not a pick list because we're building it here. And also program. So that's kind of a junction object with added units of measure. And because we've just created them, this makes it easy because the benefit type is just the equipment distribution, the program is food systems development, and the unit of measure is the dollar value. We're going to mark it active. And then in a future video, we can talk about this benefit disbursement field set and the benefits of working with that. And then last is there's some additional options that we can talk about as well, but let's do that in a future video. Let me save it. And looking at our all benefits with details, we just built food systems, so you can see that it's actually built out here with dollar value. And that leads us to the last step here, which is to schedule and track disbursements. So we'll do that in the next video.